Earlier, Niti Aayog gave a deadline to ban all ICE-driven two-wheelers under 150cc by 2025 and three-wheelers by 2023. Niti Aayog had asked manufacturers to prepare a plan of action for the next 5 years to make the transition to EVs. In case the companies fail to meet the deadline, the government plans to impose the polluter pays principle. The pollution has to be compensated and the manufacturer also pays for the cost of environment degradation. After the GST on electric vehicles reduced to 5% in India, prices of electric vehicles in India slightly reduced. Companies like Ather Energy and Avera Motors officially announced their updated electric scooter prices. Delhi government reduced the rates of charging stations of electric rickshaws and other electric vehicles. Earlier, the charging rates for 1 kilowatt is 5.5 rupees. Now, the new tariff plan reduced to 4.5 rupees per kilowatt. EESL has made offers to lease EVs to Ola Cabs, Uber, SoftBank Group Corporations, and Meru Cabs. Earlier, EESL had an agreement with electric taxi startup Blue Smart Mobility for 500 electric cars. Hindustan Copper Limited expects electric vehicles industry will increase the demand growth for copper in India. The company expecting demand for copper due to electric vehicles will increase by 1,700 kiloton by 2027. Electric vehicle export to start in Bengaluru from August 2nd to August 5th. Electric two-wheeler and three-wheeler manufacturers will exhibit their products at the expo. Electricvehicles.in motto is keeping the earth a safer place to live for the next generations. If you want to join our movement, you can support simply subscribing to our channel or sharing our videos or commenting on videos. Thanks for watching.